Welcome back, guys. We're going to try to do this again. I've already recorded this once yesterday, and you'll notice that the safe video went out, but the update video didn't because the YouTube didn't like processing. It got to 95% three times and got stuck. So we're going to try to do this again. This time we got a little extra to do because there's been another update come out since. First thing is, if you do any multiplayer testing with the safes, let Greg know what you found. If any different than what we found when we went out in the desert and played around with them and blew them up. He did change one thing with them, and that is this mechanical one. If you shift click it, it will automatically be yours. You do not have to open the door. But if you don't shift click it on, then it will be whoever opens it the first time is the owner, like you've seen in the video. Now, let's get to the actual updates here. Get back up here on my overlook perch. Alright, so first thing is he removed lots of code which changed the number over to what it is. Because of that, you need to update IHL if you're using IHL. And any other mods that use the Gregtech API or look at its coding, I guess. Pigs now drop bacon and ham. You see, here's the raw bacon, which you can use as raw meat, or you can cook it, and you're supposed to be able to make the bacon sandwich with it, but I forgot to bring that issue up to Greg, so I need to do that in the morning because it's not craftable right now. Ham as well. Same thing here, you got your raw ham, which can be used in your recipes for food. You can then cook it, and you got your regular stuff for food that way, and then you also have sliced ham and cooked sliced ham, which I do not see a way of cooking or cutting at the moment. So I'll have to ask Greg about that one as well. And let's see. Cows now drop ribs and ribeye steaks. You have your raw ribs. Again, you can use them in your food recipes or you can cook them. Same thing. And then your ribeyes, same thing, but it looks like it's in, he changed it so certain ones use certain things instead of everything just being meat. You have certain ones that take steak, certain ones that take ribs, certain ones that take bacon, whatever. Let's see. Any eye bug where certain recipes are not showing up for the crucible. As far as I know, Ilmet was one of them that wasn't showing up in there to be able to cook titanium. And another one was Tungstate. was not showing up as well for making tungsten. And those are now showing up. If there's any other ones, you might want to check. But they should be showing up now. The smelter being able to smelt ore stuff like bauxite into aluminum has been taken out. So you cannot put bauxite into a smelter and now get aluminum out of it. But something that is later on in the changelog is the fact that you can now use your molds with a pipe, if I open this the correct way, and close this. You gotta make sure your pipe has enough bandwidth to kick everything through in one pour. So you have to have, if it's one ingot's worth, you gotta have at least a bandwidth of 144. And let's see here, if I can find, I cleared out my inventory yesterday to go do that explosion testing. So I don't have anything on me at the moment, but I will light this bad boy up and show you that you can use your molds with the smelter. So if you're tired of using a crucible for everything, you can now use the smelter. Now, I'm not sure, you guys can do the math yourself and find out. I know the extruder is the most expensive way to do it, but I don't know if the smelter is along the same lines or not. But you'll see our aluminum is in there. You won't have to worry as much about things overheating and blowing up like you do with your crucible. Well, not blowing up, but burning down, because you can see this will just waste the power. Can still be automated with the redstone. Just use this here, put a hopper underneath it, right click on, well, actually you shouldn't even have to do that because that's going to auto pour out. So the only thing you have to do is put a hopper under it, and it'll automatically pull the ingot out for you and put it into a chest just like this. Like I said, y'all can do the math. Figure out what's cheaper, if it's waiting on the crucible to warm up or running it through a smelter. Now, the smelter is a bit more expensive. If I can spell. Let's see. Smelter takes a tungsten crucible, so you will have to wait until you get up to tungsten to make one. That way it can do every level of material up to that point. And there really isn't anything, unless you're doing adamantium, that's above it. And let's see here. That takes care of the mold now inputting fluid. Improve the render relation related thing a bit more by rendering calls to get tile entity. In the 6.0.2.01, there was another render change which should stop all of these power converter blocks from flickering, which should stop block updates. Let's see, there's a lot of machines that have been changed to allow inventory input from the tank input side as well. Should not break any of your automations, just allow you to input items in the fluid side. You'll just have to use a pipe or a hopper to put it in because it will not do it automatically. Did it also for the inputs for items, so both of them should be either or, but not automatic for both. So you should be able to put things into either input, just make sure you hopper them in or pipe them in, if it's not the auto side. The bath had its auto fluid output changed to the bottom instead of the back. This bad boy right here. So it used to be back here. It's not here anymore. It's now underneath here. There was nothing that you could output from it up till now. I'm not even sure if there is anything now. But so you shouldn't have to worry about that breaking any of your automation setups. Silk touch on small ores increases the percentage of a good gem. And if you can somehow combine fortune and silk touch, they would stack together. So you would get a chance at multiple with better gem. Some compatibility for extra biomes XL and biomes of funny stuff in regards to items and recipes. I do not have either of those mods, so I can't really tell you what they are. You'll have to check it out. If anybody does have those mods, please leave a comment to let us know what things have changed. And that way everybody that does have it, or at least wants to know if they should use it, can read it. Wooden buckets have been added. They can only carry milk and water. So you can't be cheap about it and just make wooden buckets forever. It's just something for early on, so you can start setting up farms and milking cows and things like that before you get to your first iron smelting. It's made same way for all of the versions except for either a copper plate, a tin plate, zinc plate, or lead plate. That little spot there, and it uses a regular hammer, not a soft hammer, because that's for bending the plate around to hold the wood together. And I have the stuff here to make one with zinc. This is another thing that's not in the changelog. You can now use your wood pulp in a compressor to make a wood plank. Now, this is not the same as the one in Gregtech 5 because it cannot be used as a cover. And XAR will be happy because it's not as ugly as what it was in Gregtech 5. He used to hate it because I would use them on pipes and stuff and he thought they were ugly. Okay, the buckets do not stack, even when they are empty. He added a recipe for being able to turn scrap into... let's see, I'll have to look up the mortar. You can use your mortar with See if it's even shows in here. Nah, it's not going to because there's a million scrap recipes. But the scrap you get from when you break tools can now be used with the mortar. 8 of them. 8 scrap in a mortar equals 8 tiny dust. Mushroom stew fluid has been added. Should also be compatible with the MFR mushroom soup fluid. So you can now make this in a mixer. It needs 1 brown mushroom and some other type of mushroom. So you can't use just red mushroom for some reason. Has to have the brown mushroom as the base. But you can use red mushroom with the brown mushroom. And you get your mushroom stew fluid. And then that can be used in a canning machine with a bowl. Why is it giving me the wrong one? To can it into a bowl of mushroom stew. So if you want to set you up a nice little automation thing to automatically kick you out bowls of mushroom stew, there you go. Let's see. Antidote pill, which will kick off your poison. Stop hitting S. See here. We'll cure your poison debuff. Uses just a brown mushroom and an empty wax capsule in your canning machine. So we got 1 new pill. And let's see. TNT recipe has changed. He did not remove the old one, but he added one with flint dust. I don't remember this one with silicon dioxide, but this is the one he mentioned. So you can now make TNT 3 different ways. And let's see. Blast resistance tool tip is now on all blocks, which I mentioned in the video for the safe. But you'll see my granite here, you have your block of black granite dust is 18, your smooth granite slab is 18, smooth black granite is 36, you know, so on and so forth. And that's on all Gregtech blocks. And vanilla TNT has a blast of 16, so you can use that to kind of judge what blocks you should put where to protect from, say, creepers, or if you're on like a server that allows PvP, you might even want to use, you know, that for that type of thing. Next would be the progress sensor can now measure the countdown value of vanilla mob spawners. And this would be the progress sensor here. So if it's at 0 and nothing's spawning, it's probably that your light levels are off. But it will do the countdown for you. Next would be the transformers for electrical power, something I am very grateful we have. Now, they are very different recipes from Gregtech 5. They now all use copper wire, 1x and 4x copper on this end, except Your bigger ones will use only annealed copper, but they are all copper. They all use the double wrought iron plates and the wire cutters. The only difference is the machine frame that is in it. You have your tin alloy, which is either a Railcraft tin plate or a Gregtech tin alloy plate, because these here are the Railcraft one that is just a tin alloy. For some reason, the rolling machine isn't showing up in NEI, but basically if you use the Railcraft rolling machine, it's two tin and two iron make a tin plate, or four tin plates. So that's why it's tin alloy. Let's see. Those go all the way up to the max voltage, but this one is not got a recipe right now. So the highest you'll be able to make is the PM to UV. Shouldn't be needing them anytime soon because we don't have anything above this one here at the moment for storage. Let's see here. Crystallization crucible. This one is a big change. This is the new way of making circuits. You will now need one of these machines to make your circuits. You have the four flavors, from steel to tungsten steel, because they use heat. And the recipe for it is an iridium smelting crucible, steel pipes, steel robust machine casing, bricks, and your double copper plate. The only thing that changes is the pipes and the casing between your recipes. So whichever flavor it is, that's flavor pipe and the flavor machine casing that you will use. So you will definitely need to find some iridium to be able to make this. Now, what that is going to make is these buells here. You have a silicon buell and a redstone alloy buell, and they are made in the crystallization crucible from either a tiny pile or a full one. We'll make you 9 of them. And you will notice you need molten silicone in there as well, with either neon, argon, and helium. Now, if you have not upgraded to O2O1, you will not have recipes for argon or neon, but that has since been fixed. You can now use nickelite, teslanite, or electrotine in a centrifuge to give you sodalite, copper, silicon dioxide, and argon. So you will need one of these spawning in your world to get argon. And let's see, neon. I thought he said he had added a recipe for it, but apparently it's not in here. And then the last one is helium, which again has changed between 0.02 and 0.02.01. You can now get it from the smelter with monazit dust, will give you rare earth and helium. You can get it from Endstone, which is the only way of getting it in 0.02 even, or from Glowstone Dust, which will now give you phosphorite, gold, silicon dioxide, and helium. Phosphorite can be electrolyzed into calcium, phosphate, and fluorine. So that's your ways of getting helium. So you will need to set all of that up so you can get you your circuit set up like we have down in the basement. So for your first electrolyzer, you will probably have to use the regular IC2 recipe. Now, one thing that has been added but is not yet used is recipes for the precision laser engraver. This block has not been added, so don't be confused by it. It's coming soon. No idea how soon is, but soon. So the recipes have been added. You will also notice that there are new circuits here. None of these have a use yet. But they are quite expensive. They need ultimate circuits and either diamond lenses or glass lenses. Why you would use diamond instead of glass, I have no idea. And a circuit plate, ultimate or platinum, and that gives you just the socket. And then the socket in a press with your plate will give you the actual processor itself, and you have a diamond, ruby, emerald, and sapphire flavor for those, which is again made in the precision laser engraver. Now let's see. Solar panels are the next big thing that was done here. And it says not to complain that they are overpowered because they put out 8 EU a tick, 1 EU at night, and they are made with 4 crystal silicon plates, 2 circuits, 10 alloy machine, 2 copper wire, 2 copper cables. Now, personally, I don't see where this is that expensive of a recipe compared to what we've had in the past. So, to me, it is a little excessive with 8. But remember, all of your machines are going to take that power and cut it in half, except for the canning machine and the electrolyzer at this time, because they all have to go through a converter block. So rather than it putting out 8 EU, it's going to be more like 4 EU, which makes it a little less of a powerful thing. So that kind of gets you to, you know, regular rather than being OP. Let's see. Next is the safes, which if you've seen the safe video, you've seen me make them, you've seen me play with them, and you also have the keys that go along with it. Let's see. There are 2 versions, the mechanical, which is what that one is, and the keyed one, both made with the same parts, just a little change in the recipe. Let's see. Safes aren't 100% blast proof. They can be blown up, as you have seen. For some reason, the mechanical one does not want to blow up. Next will be the stone generator. which is this little thing right here, which can be put into machines to create stone objects, like stone slabs, or in the engraver one, we get it to make your chiseled stone, in a shredder to make stone dust, lathe to make long stone rods, crusher to make your cobblestone, so that's how you'll do a cobblestone generator if you want. Extruder will make all of your stone tools if you want them, plates, rods, and you can do stone bricks with an ingot shape, and you can do stone itself with the block shape. Now, another thing I want to bring up about the block shape is you should now be able to do glass. Can't remember if I said this in a previous video, but you should now be able to make it in an extruder with your glass dust or sand and the extruder shape. So that is awesome. If you have AE2 and a hammer and you get a meteor to spawn in the desert, that is a great place to go and just smash glass into dust. You can bring that back and stick it in the extruder and get you some glass. Alright, so next thing on the list is going to be the item and fluid filters. These are kind of like the extenders. You have your item, your fluid, and your item and fluid. They are crafted with platinum item pipes or galvanized steel pipes, and then galvanized steel machine casing, zinc hammer wrench, and for the big one, you're going to use all of that and a robust galvanized. And this will allow you to filter fluids and items coming out of your machines or out of a pipe. I'm very happy that it's here, mainly for recipes like this, where you're going to have carbon and copper, which isn't a major thing because those can go in the same chest, but it also puts out water and oxygen as fluids. So it'll be nice to be able to pump both of them out the side of the machine, send it through a fluid filter, send your water off one way and oxygen off another way. So a great addition. Very happy that it is here. Now that's it for the 02 update. Now we're going to go to the 01 update. First thing is the energy converter blocks and transformers. Now only update their active state once every 64 ticks. And the flickering and blinking state, in order to save on graphical updates and data packs, so you should have less lag. I'm hoping that will help with the lag that I get from the Crucible. Because I only get it on the server. Single player, don't get any lag when I use it, but the Crucible really does lag me here on the server. This is where it says that he added recipes for helium and argon. Okay, it doesn't say neon, so neon doesn't have a recipe yet. The sneaking for the safe that I mentioned. If you guys watched the video where I was making my first energy circuits with Gregtech machinery, you will have heard this thing making an electrical sound. It will now not do that anymore. He has updated the sound to it to be more of a mechanical sound rather than an electrical sound. Red alloy and signalium wire will no longer emit light, which we can come over here and check that out. I always thought that was kind of weird because it was only supposed to be the aluminum wire that output light, but you can see that the light is not changing here. The light level is not changing on it like it was before. Oh, wait a minute, it looks like it still is. So it is still outputting light, because that is definitely not coming from the... Yeah, it's definitely lit up. Maybe it's putting out less? To say something to Greg about that as well. But you can kind of see there the lag I was talking about when the crucible's on. I guess I am still getting it. Doesn't seem to be quite as bad. But I think that's due to internet. You know, I have a pretty crappy internet. And the amount of packets that have to be, or information that has to be sent for the update, because this is updating so quickly. That's why I have it, and most people here on the server don't. It's mainly just me. But that's, like I said, because I have very crappy internet. And then the last thing is the seafoam issue, that it was not going on to the scaffold, which I want to try if I can find my thing of seafoam here. It, if you remember when I did it, the seafoam went onto the outside of the scaffold rather than on the scaffold itself, and then I could break this seafoam and collect it. And that was supposed to be only if it was on the scaffold. It was supposed to go around the scaffold, and then you could harvest it. And after that explosion the other day, I can't figure out where I put it, because I just started dumping stuff to be able to pick everything up before it despawned. And so I don't see where I dropped it at. So I guess we will check that out later on when I can get a little more organized after my explosion. Look one more place real quick, which I guess I already looked here, and I don't see it. So that's it for today. Hopefully YouTube doesn't have an issue with letting this go up this time. I don't know what its issue was last time, but we will hopefully be getting this out to you today. Hope you enjoyed. If you got anything you need to tell me, leave it in the comments, and I will be glad to answer them or share it with everybody else in the next video. Oh, look at that. Found it. So, let's go spray this, and then I will let you guys go for the day. So, there we go. It definitely did. It breaks the structure, though. But it definitely does go on the scaffold now. So I guess I'm kind of stuck in the basement until that hardens. There is a hardening spray that I probably ought to make. Let's see. There it is, hardening spray. It's just sand and a spray can and that makes your hardening spray. So probably ought to make that. But that's it. Take it easy. Have a good one.